Hello, Deployment Insiders, and welcome back to another episode from my home. I know you haven't seen me in a while, and that's mainly because we've been working really hard, just like I know you all have been, to manage this whole work from home situation. But for those of you who are here for the very first time, this channel is set up to deliver you with tips, tricks, and best practices to make your office deployment much easier. And now that I have a home studio set up, we'll be releasing more videos. So click on the subscribe button and hit on that bell icon to make sure you don't miss out on any of the new information. Now, in today's video, we're going to be talking about some changes to the delivery channel, as well as introduce you to a new channel. So let's get started. As I hinted a moment ago, we have some updates that frankly, I'm excited to share with you today. And if you haven't heard by now, let me be the first to tell you that Office 365 Pro Plus has a new name, Microsoft 365 Apps for Enterprises. From a technical capabilities, it doesn't change how you deploy or manage these apps throughout its life cycle, but it does align us closer to the vision of the Microsoft line of productivity tools, which is to provide organizations with an integrated set of apps and services that puts artificial intelligence and other cutting-edge innovations to work for you. And there's some really cool, exciting new features and services that we'll continue to deliver throughout the year and beyond. And as usual, I've gone ahead and posted the link to the blog article and our official documentation in the description area below. Now that you're up to date on the new name, let's talk about the new capabilities that we recently announced back in May. The new monthly enterprise channel. What is that you say? We already have a monthly channel? Well, the feedback was loud and clear. You wanted an update channel that wasn't as slow to receive quality fixes and feature updates like the semi-annual channel. And you didn't want updates to always be as frequent as the current monthly channel, especially a more predictable rhythm that your users will be more excited about. So we came up with a monthly enterprise channel. So how would you determine which of your users within the organization should be on this new channel? Well, frankly, I would select users that are using the Microsoft 360 app as a general purpose set of tools. So what do I mean by this? Well, those are the typical users who do not have any critical line of business add-ins, macros, or applications that they're using in order to generate IP on those devices. Instead, they're using things like Word to collaborate and generate basic documents, to be able to consume documents using PowerPoint and Outlook in the same manner. Now, what do you do with your other set of users who are using critical line of business applications, add-ins, and macros? They would be the great fit for the semi-annual channel, which they can continuously get their fixes and feature updates twice a year. Now, here are a couple of things that you should note. First, there is no preview channel for the new monthly enterprise channel, like we do have for the other channels that we offer today. That's mainly because the updates are just cumulative of the current monthly channel builds that we deliver there. That also means that we offset the delivery of the build in the monthly enterprise channel by 6 to 8 weeks. And finally, the existing monthly channel that we've been talking about will be renamed to help reduce any confusion. So from today, we're gonna call it the current channel. So am I saying that you should not be using the current channel? Absolutely not. For users who want the latest and greatest features that our services are offering, the current channel is the best choice. In fact, any new tenant being provisioned will have the current channel as the default for self-service options. If you think about it, prior to delivering cloud services, by this I mean Exchange Online, SharePoint Online, Teams, and so on, we used to release the on-prem server versions. At the same time, we released the Office client bits to ensure that users were able to take advantage of the new features built into the servers. In an online services world, we do the same thing by releasing the features in the services as well as in the client through the current channel. Now, all these changes are being reflected in our current tool set, whether you're using device settings within config.office.com, Configuration Manager, the Office Deployment Toolkit, or Microsoft Intune. At the same time, we have ensured to make all of the channel names backward compatible so you don't have to go back to all your saved XML files and update them. I know there's been a lot of information that I just said here, so let's do a quick recap. Office 365 Pro Plus is now Microsoft 365 Apps for Enterprise. Monthly channel has been renamed Current Channel, while we introduce the new monthly enterprise channel. So don't worry, I know you don't have to memorize all of this over here because we've added all the links and the information to the official documentation below. Now, after you move some or all of your users to the new monthly enterprise channel, you'll want to think about the best way to manage the updates. Although you can manage the updates through tools such as Configuration Manager, we recommend getting the updates directly from the CDN, especially for those of you who have a large workforce working from home today. This will ensure that they are up to date on all the latest quality fixes and security updates. And we've already started seeing a large number of organizations switch to the new monthly enterprise channel, and I hope you'll consider it too. And as a bonus, keep an eye out on some of the new capabilities that will help you better cloud manage this new channel. That's all I can say for now. I hope you enjoyed the new update, so let me know what you think in the comments below. And as a reminder, don't forget to click on the subscribe button and notification icon to know when we release new videos. Also, if you have any topics you want to hear about on this channel, or even have a feature that you would like for us to build, head on over to the User Voice site. And if you want to continue the discussion about this or any other Office related topics, head over to the Tech Community site where you'll be able to chat with myself or a member of the engineering team, and of course with other IT admins from all around the world. As always, we'll be adding the links in the description below, so we'll hope to see you there. Until then, stay safe, stay positive, and keep on deploying.